Hello, good morning Indonesia. It is 20 October 2020 Tuesday. You are still with me, Desni Aviva in CNN Indonesian News. Here I will deliver news that is appalling Indonesia, namely the demonstrations against the Omnibus Law, and this is the news in details. Well viewers, you can see the situations here is very chaotic because thousands of Indonesia's university students in various regions have once again taken to the streets to protest the revisions of several laws, including the one on corruption eradication commissions and criminal code. In Jakarta, students from various universities, including from outside the capital city, staged protests in front of the House of Representatives building Tuesday, demanding the legislature cancel the passage of the controversial bills as they were regressive to democracy. The students, among others, came from the University of Indonesia, the State University of Jakarta, Trisakti University, Veterans State University, the University of Gajah Mada, Pajajaran University, and the Bandung Institute of Technology. In the afternoon, thousands of police officers guarding the parliament building tried to pressure the students to leave the parliament compound by using water cannons and tear gas, while students posed at the parliament building's guard. The Jakarta police deployed some 80,000 police officers to guard the parliament building. The protests began in the morning and lasted until evening. In solidarity with the students in Jakarta, thousands of university students across Indonesia staged similar protests in Solo, Palembang, Medan, Bandung, Garut, Malang, Surabaya, Yogyakarta, Makassar, Denpasar, Tarakan, and Palangkaraya. The rally in Makassar, South Sulawesi turned chaotic when students threw stones and police fired tear gas shells and beat up students with clubs. Three journalists, including the ones from Ancora News Agency and Makassar Today Online Media, were injured as they were also beaten up by police officers. The police tried to stop the journalists from taking pictures of students being beaten up. Ishak, a journalist from Makassar Today, said that the police catches so much and back for not obeying their order. As per Muhammad Darwin Fatir, a journalist from Ancora News, was pulled into a hallway and beaten up. Similar rallies have been taking place for the past several days across Indonesia. Well viewers, that's all the news for today. For more information, you can check our website in www.cnnindonesia.com. Don't forget to always apply the health protocol for everywhere you go. And I'm Desni Hafifa, reporting from the scene of the crime, saying thank you so much for watching. Take care for yourself and goodbye.